Mr. Wainthrop's worried. He told me to ride shotgun.
A string of violent thefts.
Did you recognise anybody?
They were masked.
And Hetty's flavour of the moment.
The men attacked work in restaurants.
They owned restaurants.
How's your meal?
Very good. It's quite hot enough for my blood.
Has she bitten off more than she can chew?
Any trouble, we'll send in the cavalry.
You.
Hetty Wainthropp Investigates, Friday at 9:30 on BBC One.
What has Mr. Jones done now?
He has killed a man.
To the jail with him!
I am innocent!
Everybody's talking at me. I can't hear a word they're saying. Only the echoes of my mind.
The gallows are much preferable to the Americas.
That vile Mr. Jones!
I'm indifferent to what happens to me.
The final chapter of Tom Jones in 15 minutes on BBC One.
£1 billion worth of bonuses awarded to the city this Christmas. Is it over the top? Ask the Money programme on BBC Two shortly. This is BBC One. Now the main evening news with Peter Sissons.
Angry farmers have stepped up their attempts to stop the import of cheap beef. But police have warned again about their tactics and their leaders have cautioned against alienating the public. Thousands of new homework clubs for problem children. The government diverts £200 million from the National Lottery. And Billy Bremner, midfield inspiration for Scotland and Leeds, has died at the age of 54. Good evening. Thousands of farmers have taken part in demonstrations across the country as they step up their campaign against the import of cheap beef. Protests were held at several key ports, including Stranraer, Dover and Plymouth. Farmers' leaders urged members to exercise restraint, and the protests were largely peaceful, though the Road Haulage Association accused some farmers of intimidating drivers. Duncan Kennedy reports.
One week into the beef price dispute, one more show of strength by beef farmers. Tonight in Dover, it was largely peaceful, but five were arrested for alleged obstruction with their tractors. Police have denied farmers' allegations they're using too much force. Lorry drivers had to face farmers at several other ports today, this one in Hull.
What cargo have you got on board?
After an exchange, the driver is called on to get out and open up his trailer, part of the farmers' attempts to halt the import of cheap beef. In the end, a handshake and a smile clears the way for the driver to continue.
OK, yeah. Much obliged.
The tone of the protests may be largely peaceful, but lorry companies say some drivers are being intimidated.
Obviously, it's a very disconcerting situation for our members. They're facing long lines of pickets. They're occasionally facing very aggressive picketing. And obviously, it's very worrying for them and very distressing for them.
And that strong ground means lower supports.
Farm leaders don't want to alienate public opinion with reports of violence. The message at this meeting in Shropshire today was to protest peacefully.
Already we're seeing warnings from the Irish government, from the road hauliers, from the EU Commission, that action can be taken if free trade is stopped. We are not in a position where we can support illegal actions.
The 200 farmers who turned up at Stranraer in Scotland today were law-abiding, earning them and other farmers the support and sympathy of the opposition.
The Conservative Party doesn't condone any illegal action, but we quite sympathise with the strong stance the farmers are taking because we think they have been pushed beyond the limits by a government that has failed to negotiate anything for them.
The government's approach in all this has been to insist and resist. Insist that the farmers stick to the rule of law, but resist calls for compensation. It's a stance that could come under increasing pressure as the dispute enters its second week. Tonight, union leaders in Scotland called for a suspension of the protest ahead of talks with the government. But it's not clear yet if the farmers themselves are in the mood for compromise. Duncan Kennedy, BBC News.
Ministers are pressing ahead with a vote this week on cutting benefits for single parents, despite evidence of a growing revolt among their backbenchers. Today, in a move designed to help the underprivileged, it was learned the government is to put £200 million of lottery money into a new chain of homework clubs to help problem children.
As many as one in ten children at GCSE level play truant.
It not only damages their education, but also hinders their chances later on in life. Homework clubs, like this one in North London, will now be extended nationwide to try to keep children in school. Just the first step in what ministers promise will be a much wider campaign to tackle what they call social exclusion.
When you have a combination of factors coming together, poverty, lack of a job, poor housing, bad health, then all too often people experience social exclusion. What we need to have is a unit at the heart of government reporting to the Prime Minister that will tackle these issues in a positive and a comprehensive way. That's exactly what this unit will do.
Tony Blair will launch the unit at a school in South London tomorrow. It'll operate across government with three key targets: to cut down on truancy, deal with the problems of homelessness, and tackle rundown housing estates. But with Mr. Blair facing his first backbench rebellion on Wednesday over cuts to lone parent benefits, the opposition smell a rat.
This is more to do with what's going on Wednesday with the lone parents issue, and another way of trying to say, look, we are doing something for those who are in difficulties at the bottom end of society. We're doing something for them, whilst busily taking away lone parent benefit.
Even with their huge majority, ministers are taking the rebellion seriously, telling all backbenchers to cancel previous engagements and be in the Commons to support the government. The lone rebels, though, are standing firm.
I'm hoping that the government won't implement these cuts. Even if the vote goes through, even if they get their legislation through, they still don't have to implement these cuts.
And the Liberal Democrats say Chancellor Gordon Brown can easily afford.
Oh no! Oh, mother! Switch!